All right, so I set this thing up last night. It said rodent caught. Let's see if there's something there. Take a look. Please don't jump out.
Example of what the packet transfer looks like. You can see that this one was sent at 4:59 a.m. Here's another one from 11 a.m., another packet transfer. So really any time that, you know, the Internet of Things are speaking with the Helium network, they're sending these small packet transfers. That is what and how it's going to show up.
Hey everybody, welcome back to Jamia's Promo. And today we will be unboxing, taking a look at, and setting up the Victor V-Link Rat Trap along with the Victor V-Link Mouse Trap. Now, both of these traps are powered by the Helium network, and a lot of people always ask questions, what exactly is the Helium network used for? They want to see real life use case scenarios, and we always talk about the Internet of Things connecting, such as dog collars, scooters, and all these other different sensors, humidity sensors, things like that, but it can also go for smart mouse traps and rat traps. So it's connecting through the Helium network with long range WAN. So it's not going with that limited distance of Bluetooth and Wi-Fi. So you have a much larger distance to get these things connected and also speak with the Helium network. So this way it can send data through applications and you can see exactly when a pest has been controlled, when the pest has been caught. So this way you know for a fact that you should take a look at your rat trap, mouse trap. So this way you don't always have to keep going down wondering if it has been caught, or maybe it's been caught for 2 weeks and you just never took a look. So really these two right here are something that is part of the solution, something that can help a lot of businesses, not really just commercial but also residential. So what we're going to do is we're going to take a look at both of these traps right here, but I also do want to show you just a few things when it comes down to the details of the V-Link. So what I'll do is I'll place this link below the video inside the description so you guys can read everything about it. So this way you guys can see exactly the partnership between Victor and also Helium, and as well as Parley Labs, because you can purchase this here from parleylabs.com. So this article right here will be placed below the video inside the description. I'll also place another link. It's a video of Victor talking about this product, going really in depth with all of the details. So as you scroll down and you read this article, this is where you can take a look at the rat trap, also the mouse trap. And then when you go through the buy now area, this is where you can, you know, choose which one you would like to go with. So if we take a look at the mouse trap right over here, a lot of the details will be listed inside of here, talking about how long the battery life would be, talking about how many times the trap would be able to be activated. This one is hygienic. It's also IP67 rated for indoor and outdoor use. 3-year battery life. There's no moving parts, things like that. If I was to show you just a couple different slide shots screenshots from the YouTube video that I will be linking below the video, you can see the deployment. The trap connects wirelessly to a hotspot or Helium network connection. Traps communicate daily to let you know current status. The communication, the data is immediately sent to the V-Link cloud using the Helium network. And then you can also take a look at notifications. Right over here, it's just talking about how it is built, how it works, how it can be used for indoor, outdoor, how effective it is, some of the latest technology that's built inside, and then just going through a whole bunch of things. So if you want to see more about this, I'll be placing the link below the video inside the description. Today's video, I just kind of really want to show you what they've physically really look like, how big they are, and then how to connect them to your phone, and then how they interact with the Helium network and how you can get data credits sent and everything like that. So first off, let's take a look at the rat trap. So inside the box is the rat trap itself. You also have your batteries to install and then a quick start guide. So if you're curious on just kind of the sizes of this one is sitting right at 18 inches long. And then we're sitting at about 6 inches wide. So these two are pretty much built the exact same. I'll open up the mouse trap in here just 1 second, but I do want to show you that these are just built, you know, really good, great quality. It's really built for outdoors as well. So if you feel like you might have an issue outside, that is where you can place it. You don't have to worry about rain or really anything else getting on the inside. Here are some of the screws that you will be using when you do place in your batteries underneath this power source right here. So the top, this is just the lid sitting right there. This is where you do have a little compartment for the attractant of the rodent. So if you do want to put in a little bit of bait it can go right inside of there. This is what the bottom does look like. Now, underneath here, you do want to take off this portion as well. So here's the other portion. You see all of the metal connections that would be pushing out the shock. And then you just kind of slide this out. And then this is where you want to go underneath, and you place in all four batteries. Now, once you have the four batteries installed, you're going to put it right back to where it was. You'll open up the V-Link application, and then you scan this code, which we're going to do here in just a second. But let's put in these batteries. So this right here simply pops right off, and make sure that once you put in your batteries, you put in all of your screws. So now that these screws are put in on the bottom, all you have to do is just replace everything back to where they were. So this one right here will slide right in just like that. You'll take this other bigger piece, place it right there, and then your very last, the top of basically the trap door, I guess you can say, this one will sit just right inside of there. Now, if you're wondering about the size of the mouse trap, this one is about 11 and a half inches long and then about 5 inches wide. So we're gonna do the exact same thing here with this one. There's only one strap, but just so you guys know, this one is basically a double tunnel. So you have a tunnel going on from each side. So this way on both locations, any rodent would be able to go in from the left or through the right-hand side. And also too, it is capable of holding two rodents at the same time. So this way you'd be able to get a notification that there's one that's been inside and trapped, but you also get another notification that the second one has been trapped. So there is basically a double notification that would let you know that this thing is just completely full. So again, here is your top door. You'll basically take this off, and this is the small little area that you place in your little rodent bait. Take off this piece right here, the portion that they run through. Then you're gonna push this on out. And then this is where you'd be able to, again, add in the batteries from the bottom. And then you screw in all the screws. Now that you have the batteries installed, you'll place it in, slide it into place. Then you're gonna grab basically this portion right here, connect that in there. Here's your top section. So here are the size comparison, direct size comparison of the two of them outside of the box. And so they are a little bit larger than what I would have thought. But again, they are a housing unit. You know, it can hold a rodent on both the left and the right hand side. It is a tunnel going all the way through. And no rat or mouse is able to go all the way through the very end. They always get stuck, caught, and then hygienically eliminated in the middle of this unit itself. So this way, again, it can hold two rodents at the exact same time. Again, if you have a rat issue, mouse issue, this right here will definitely get them all eliminated. So it is actually the next morning. Last night I unboxed these things and I did finally figure out how to connect these mouse traps to the Victor V-Link application. There was a portion I was going through all of these different steps right here, and I figured there would be something I'd be able to find with this link here, but I did overlook on the very top that you do need to make sure you go to vlinkhq.com, that you can log in and create your account. So here is what it was talking about. If you do want to head straight into portal.vlinkhq.com, make sure you log in, sign in. That is where you add in your rooms, you add in your building, because this could be residential, commercial, and you'd want to put in, you know, which floor it's in, what room it's in. So if you have a huge building, you could put floor 1 or floor 5, room 6B, whatever the case. So for me, because it's at home, I'm just putting, you know, first floor, second floor, basement, things like that. So this is the website you do want to make sure you take a look at. You have to add in your room first before you go into the V-Link application to add this to a room. So once the room has been created on that website, I can't really show you because it has my personal information. Once you add in the room, then this is where you scan in this code over here, which is what we are about to do. So if we head inside of the V-Link application, I'm located, I'm going to put this one outside. So I named this room outside back door, just because I know some rodents could be back there. And I also want to test this outside with the IP67 as well. So this is where you want to go, and you want to hit on scan. And then once you scan the code, you press the power button so it blinks green. And then now it's going to connect to this. So this is where you can add in a name if you want to. So this one I might also put in, you know, just outdoor. Now, once you have that one finished, you can add a note. Then you go to complete setup.
So now it's going to connect and add this trap. It takes about a minute. And then once it states that it has been connected, which it just, you know, has right now, this is where you want to head off and you want to close this up. And if you do want to put in a bait, you can put a little bit of bait inside of here. The one that I used, which you'll actually notice here coming up right next, is I did catch a mice last night, and I put a little bit of peanut butter inside of here. You want to have something that is sweet or something that is fatty. And once you have your bait in there, you basically just close this up. And then you just deploy it, put it wherever you want it to go. And that's really about it. Now, there is a couple things I do want to show you with this application, you know, with me catching a mouse and things like that. And I want to show you what it looks like when you do have your rat traps, the mouse traps, really anything that is connected through the Helium network. This is what you will be earning. It is called a packet transfer. So as you know, you get your proof of coverage, your challenger. You also get witnessing in terms of earning your Helium. Now, when you do speak to anything that is on the Helium network, if it's these traps, if it's farming equipment in the future, if it is tracking dog collars so you can locate your lost pet, if it's those Lime scooters, humidity sensors, water sensors, door sensors, things like that, this is really where you'll be able to earn your Helium after a while when the rewards of the Helium speaking to each other goes down. So a lot of people are talking about the halving of Helium in the future, and at some point you might not earn as much Helium from the coverage speaking to each other. You'll be earning a lot when it comes down over into the packet transfer. So this is what it looked like here. It had a red little box with a number 1 letting me know that something has been caught. It was the one that was in the unfinished basement. And then it shows the screen here. You can record the activity. So I recorded that there was something caught. You can see the battery life of the trap along with the signal, making sure you do have good signal strength. Here is another example of what the packet transfer looks like. You can see that this one was sent at 4:59 a.m. Here's another one from 11 a.m., another packet transfer. So really anytime that, you know, the Internet of Things are speaking with the Helium network, they're sending these small packet transfers. That is what and how it's going to show up. So you can see it's going to be a little bit smaller than witnessing, you know, things like that and what the rewards are. So again, if we go back to this one, this was from 11:56 p.m. I believe I had this connected at 11:30. So just 20, 30 minutes later was when it already started speaking with my Helium network here, you know, passing off that packet transfer. So now let me show you what it looked like from this morning when I woke up with the application in hand, and we took a look at what we caught.
All right, so I set this thing up last night, put it in the basement. You can see that it's technically at my home. Then I put basement, and then you have to add a room. So I put basement. It said rodent caught. Let's see if there's something there. So just had it sitting right here, unfinished basement. Let's take a look. Please don't jump out. There he is. And there he is. Laid at rest. So it says in the instructions that after about 15, 20 kills, just make sure to clean the trap, clean the compartment. So we're gonna leave this right here. It has been successful, only one night. This, what I used for a bait trap was peanut butter. So they say use something fatty or sweet, something like cheese or peanut butter. Lock back up. And go for round 2.
So here's a closer look at the application. This is the V-Link application, and I will be blacking out the very top just so it doesn't show my information. But you can see that for the site view, it'll show all the different areas that you have a trap that is set up. So you can see here underneath the home for the floor of basement, there's two different rooms. I have the basement, and then the outside back door. So this one will be going outside just because I do want to play with that IP67. So this is where you can see all of the traps at this location. And then again, if you wanted to take a look at one particular, just to make sure that it has good battery and also good signal, this is how you can also keep track of all of those, making sure that you don't have to replace the batteries yet and making sure that you still do have a very good connection with the Helium network. So that is it for today's video. You guys saw me unbox this thing, set up this thing. There's a few things I couldn't really show you. I showed you what it looks like when they're actually speaking into the Helium network, anything of the Internet of Things, you know, transferring the packet transfer, which gives you the rewards in Helium. Showed you what it looked like if there is something that is caught, the identification that something has been caught, the information of all of the traps, things like that. And really, I showed you the sizes, compared the two for the rat and for the mouse. I'll be placing these links below the video inside the description if you guys want to get them from Parlay Labs. And honestly, here, I knew for a fact at my home there was a mouse. I know we have at least a few mice running around. I see their little droplings here and there. We have an unfinished basement. And so it makes me super happy that I was able to put one of these up, deploy it up, and overnight was able to catch one for today's video, which is actually super cool. So this way you guys saw everything it could do, not only just the setup, the way that it looks, what it looks like when you earn Helium from these things, but also that it does eliminate the issue, eliminate the problem in a humane way where you're not going to have a big metal thing clasp on top of them violently, something that is very quick, easy, and the most peaceful way for them to go, so they don't harm your building, your residential house, whatever the case. But that is it for today's video. Give this thing a big thumbs up. Also hit that subscribe button right over here. And if you appreciated this video, then more than likely you'll also like this video. And now you guys see exactly what the power of the Helium network could do, the People's Network. And I'll see you guys later.